So without any further ado, Colonel Ryan Samuelson.
Well, thank you very much. You know, normally I give a lot of briefs and speeches out amongst the community, but I sometimes don't use a lot of notes and I just talk to you. I don't want to get anything wrong tonight, so I'm going to read from prepared statements that I have, just so that I'm very clear in the message and what I have to say. Ladies and gentlemen, neighbors and community partners, thank you all for coming out tonight to learn more about the groundwater contamination issue as it relates to both private and municipal wells. I'm not usually known for addressing things in the inland northwest and Fairchild that what we're doing, and I'm usually known for addressing the great things that we in the inland northwest and Fairchild Air Force Base are doing together and how our 75 years of partnership grow stronger every day. But regrettably, this meeting is different. We take pride in defending this great nation and its citizens, and to be honest, we are pained when our actions may have led to potential harm. Many of you have heard me say that my family's been in the Air Force for three generations, and I've been in for 23 years, and yet never have I seen a community the size of the inland northwest support its base like it does here. In my 23 years, I've never seen it. So the stewardship of our solid relationship is something I think about every single day as your base commander. You deserve to know what we know, because this is a concern for all of us. This has become a community-wide issue that's going to take our combined efforts to resolve. I am confident our long-standing positive relationship will help us succeed to that end. This past week's response in water distribution and our partnership with the city of Airway Heights, I think, is a prime example. We take our responsibility to keep you informed and to take appropriate actions to ensure safe drinking water seriously. Throughout this process, we wanted to make sure you had insights into the testing results immediately to ensure we all have information to make informed decisions for ourselves and our families. We did not wait weeks or even months at Fairchild Air Force Base to share information. We did not wait a year for a full investigation to conclude and point to sources. We received the results, and the same day we shared those results. All of us at Fairchild Air Force Base eat, play, and live in Airway Heights and the surrounding community. Our goal from the onset of this has been transparency, and that is why we're here this evening. This public meeting was not directed by the Air Force or Air Force. It was done to inform those of us who live on the West Plains. I understand many of you have questions and concerns, as you are, and I appreciate your willingness to come here to hopefully find answers and assurance that we, along with our regulatory partners and our city leaders, are doing all that we can, as quickly as we can, to protect our health and prevent any future issues. I'll be honest, I'm not here to talk in bureaucratic speech with words that leave you guessing what the heck I'm talking. I am here to honestly tell you what we know at this point and to learn from you what thoughts, questions, or concerns you have that remain unanswered. My expectation is for you to leave better informed and that I leave with lots of to-dos to answer your questions. You will never, under my command, hear words like no comment or Fairchild was unavailable to answer. Every news outlet may call me 24/7 for answers, and they know that. I have not denied one engagement request, nor request for information, and I have met with them 19 times in the last 7 days. There's been a lot of information out there in the news, on social media and other websites in the past few weeks. Unfortunately, a lot of it has been misleading, not put into the proper context, or flat out wrong. What we hope here to do tonight is to afford you the opportunity to hear the information straight from the experts who are in charge with those particular topics. Those who have come here from all over the state and country, from a variety of organizations, not just the Air Force, to help all of us leave with a better informed understanding of how we are going to move forward together in this. We did not share each other's speeches or topics for discussion, but I have invited the City of Airway Heights, the EP,
EPA, the Health Department, and the Spokane Regional Health Department as well to this meeting. I just asked that they provide as much factual information to help all of us as they could, as they possibly could. And the Air Force intends to do the same with you tonight. So, how did we get here today? This is not a very simple question to answer, but I will do my best to provide a brief summary. The firefighting foam used has been used since before I was born. And we stopped using it before me and most of the leadership on base were even assigned. In 2009, the Environmental Protection Agency published provisional health advisories for the compounds known, and I'm not going to pretend to pronounce them in their full names, but known as PFOS and PFOA, based on the evidence available at the time. The science has evolved greatly since then, and the EPA replaced the provisional health advisories from 2009 with a new lifetime exposure health advisory in May of 2016. That is to say, a lifetime of 70 years. These advisories last year are what triggered the Air Force to begin proactively sampling on, and if necessary, around installations to determine if elevated levels were present. Under the EPA, the established lifetime health advisory was set at 70 parts per trillion. However, there was no actionable standard prior to that by which to test, nor have there been any legal or statutory requirements to do so since PFOS and PFOA are still unregulated and considered emerging contaminants by the EPA. However, the EPA is actively studying these compounds and, out of an abundance of caution, has stated that ingesting them at levels above the health advisory over one's lifetime could potentially be harmful to human health. Standards are also developed for our most vulnerable population, the developing child of a mother, and they don't leave our bodies rapidly if ingested. The Air Force, however, depends on the EPA and the Department of Health and Human Services for Toxic Substance and Disease Registry to determine danger to human health and the environment. It is important to note that these compounds have been used in household and commercial products since the 1950s, and contamination found in this area could also have occurred at any point since then from a variety of military, commercial, and industrial sources. These compounds, as you may have read, have been used in many products, such as stains, carpets, greases, rain-resistant clothing, furniture, fast food, and popcorn bag packaging, and yes, firefighting foam used by many aviation fields. The Food and Drug Administration, in fact, did not even ban the use of PFOA in food packaging until January of last year. Because of its widespread use in carpets, upholstered furniture, and other textiles, PFOA has been detected in indoor dust from homes, offices, vehicles, and other indoor spaces. Their use, in fact, has been so widespread for so long that science indicates most, if not all of us, some level of PFOS and PFOA in our bodies. According to the EPA study released last year, PFOA was detected in the bloodstream of 99% of the U.S. general population between 1999 and 2012. Well, a version of aqueous form-filling foam, I will call it AFFF from now on, is a very effective firefighting foam that contains PFOS and PFOA. And it's been used for military and commercial aircraft fire protection worldwide since the 1970s, including here at Fairchild Air Force Base. That is why, after looking at how the foam was used at Fairchild Air Force Base, particularly in the southeast training section of our base, the Air Force moved forward with well water testing. First on base, then outside the immediate area, and then we've continued to expand every week since we first tested. The Air Force did not conduct a health study on the impacts of AFFF foam itself. The early 1980s study referenced by some news sources was not a study on AFFF, nor was the chemical in that study used by the Air Force for any other purpose than of the initial study. The Air Force is investigating to determine if our mission activities are a potential source that has contributed to this problem by using the old AFFF to put out aircraft fires and train our firefighters over the past few decades. But we are also not waiting for legislation or regulations to move forward and to act. After the EPA's advisory in 2009, the Air Force began looking for ways to limit the use of our old AFFF and eventually replace it with a more environmentally friendly alternative that would still effectively protect lives and aircraft. You see, aircraft fires simply can't be put out with water and most basic firefighting foams. We started using an improved, more efficient, more environmentally friendly foam last year, very shortly after the EPA released their May 2016 health advisory levels on PFOS and PFOA, and as soon as it was approved by the Department of Defense. Additionally, Fairchild stopped using it for training over 2 years ago. In order to ensure the health and well-being of our communities, the Air Force is conducting a proactive process to identify, to respond, and prevent as it relates to the potentials of PFOS and PFOA contamination, and to begin sampling groundwater wells in areas where we know or suspect AFFF has been used in the past. This is exactly what led to the sampling on base, as well as private and municipal wells within approximately 2 miles to the south and east of the base's eastern fence line in the past few months, in what has been noted as round one and round two of sampling. Again, there was no other state or federal government agency that directed the Air Force to begin this testing. PFOS, PFOA, and drinking water are not regulated by the Safe Drinking Water Act. The Air Force did not wait for federal laws for monitoring and testing to change before moving forward. Fairchild first sent our teams off base to inform well owners, these were private well owners, of the potential issue and requested permission to sample their wells in the suspected contamination areas. As soon as we had the results, we immediately informed the residents and provided bottled water to affected personnel. We are now working with these residents one-on-one and our local and regional partners to find a long-term solution to provide them with clean drinking water. And you have my word that I will follow up on this every single day. We need to fix it fast. Each house and well will have to be looked at differently to find the best solution. But for me, living on bottled water is not an acceptable solution. I will be your advocate as we work through this. After the first round of testing, the Air Force approved additional testing at a further distance to the east and to the south of base. As soon as we received the results of round two, we not only did the same thing for private well owners as we did in round one, but we also immediately, the same day I had the test, informed the city of Fairway Heights of those results. And this prompted the city, out of an abundance of caution and care for the community, to take the actions that I will let Mr. Albert Tripp discuss in a few minutes. Needless to say, the base is partnering with the city to find solutions and investigate all possible sources of the PFOS, PFOA contamination, such as landfills, commercial sources, and wastewater treatment plants, just to name a few. Let me also state that Fairchild Air Force Base will not release the details of private or municipality well testing results to anyone other than the owner of the well, whether that be a private citizen or the city of Airway Heights. Because for me, this should be treated like someone's private medical data. If those individuals so choose to release, that is really up to them. The reason is that this is a complex issue. Along one such road, we find four neighbors, all living on the exact same street, or close to one another, that have four readings that go all the way from no detection to right next door, many times the health advisory levels. So many factors play into what potentially could contaminate a well. What we are finding is the age of the well, the structure of the well, the depth of the well, the water flow both on the surface and underground all play in to whether or not chemical contamination from PFOS and PFOA is found. It would be an error for anybody to draw a conclusion that our sample testing areas that you'll see on the maps represent plumes of contamination. It is just simply not the case. It is independent based on the wells that we are finding and testing. In fact, between the base and the Airway Height affected municipal wells, we have wells, four of them, that did not contain any PFOS, PFOA compounds. Again, it is a complex problem that will require extensive investigation, but I will tell you that does not change our support to the community in getting water to those who may need it. Further private well testing. My guess is that many of you are here to have that question answered. Headquarters Air Force is working with Fairchild Air Force Base in taking a proactive measure approach to sampling additional off-base private wells. That is to say, we are starting with the areas that are likely affected the most, areas where we know we have activity, and moving out from there if necessary. During the site inspection phase, we have identified wells to be sampled based on, number one, probability of contamination, proximity to the contaminant area, and possible pathways from the contaminant to the drinking water wells. If your drinking water well is within a sample area and you have not been contacted, then please contact us, even if it's not on a map currently, this evening or at our public affairs phone number. If the site indication indicates your well might be impacted, we may be able to go out and continue to sample. If you are still concerned, after talking with our hydrogeologist and looking at our maps, and you're not within the current testing area, please do not leave without us documenting where you live so we can get experts to look at your unique location and situation. We care tremendously about the health and well-being of our families, our neighbors, our community partners. And we understand those impacted or potentially impacted by this emerging issue have legitimate concerns. I'd like to encourage everyone to take the time you need tonight to learn about what PFOS and PFOA are, how they might affect human health if consumed at certain levels over one's lifetime, and what the Air Force and our partners have done and will continue to do to identify, respond, and prevent. We will continue to remain completely transparent as we work to determine the extent of PFOS, PFOA contamination, and how to quickly and effectively provide clean water to those possibly affected by any past activities associated with base operations. We are providing water to the public. We are providing water to the affected businesses. We are providing manpower to help each other, all while heavily deployed to over 19 locations around the globe, and we will continue to do so. And while we don't yet know the full extent to which past-based activities have contributed to the PFOS, PFOA contamination in this area, or what part non-military sources may have played, the Air Force, your Fairchild, is committed to working with our city regulatory partners, most important to me, to the residents, to protect human health and resolve the issue at hand. I will remain fully accessible to any member of the community, city leadership, or media outlets that have questions, and to ensure the public knows that the great patriots of Fairchild Air Force Base are here to help and not to hurt. I will not delegate the tough questions nor leave the tough decisions and discussions on the side. We want our base and communities we live in to be clean and as friendly as possible. We want to be the great neighbors that you want living next to you. Let me close by saying thank you to those who have stopped by the water distribution sites or left messages to say thank you for your support and help. No one who serves at Fairchild Air Force Base made decisions on what products to use to conduct our activities. No one intentionally made decisions to harm ourselves or the community of partners in areas that we live. This was not a spill covered up overnight by Team Fairchild. And please, for some of you, let your frustrations not be with the men and women, active guard, reserves, civilians, and families who call Fairchild home. If you do have frustrations related to base activities, give them to me. And I will work tirelessly with you and my higher headquarters to get a resolution as soon as possible. Our patriots defend with their lives this great country. Please continue to support them as you have for decades. Again, we care about solving the problem, and we care about protecting our environment and leaving a legacy that generations to come can enjoy. Transparency and accessibility are my top keywords in this week. It has been the basis of our 75-year partnership through great times and, yes, tough times. With that, Mr. Albert Chairman.